Welcome to the 12th grade course registration tutorial for RenWeb, brought to you by the ISP Educational Technology Department. I am your tutorial host, Dr. Nicole Yimothy, and I am the ISP Technology Integration Coordinator. For tech support, please remember to contact us via email at edtechhelp@isp.edu.pa or come by the Tech Center that is located in the above the elementary gym at the top of the stairs down the hall from the nurse. We're open Monday to Friday from 6:45 to 4:30 p.m. for support. Today, the goal with this tutorial is to get you to remember where to access RenWeb as a student, where to locate the Change Your Password feature within RenWeb, and to walk you through the online registration process specific to your grade for the coming school year. So go ahead and get started today. We're going to need a computer that's connected to the internet. You'll need to have your ISP-issued email address and the district code for the RenWeb program of IS-PAN. You'll also need your password. The default password set last year at this time for all high school students was ISP12345. However, students were also instructed at this time for their initial login to reset their password to something that they'll remember. If you don't remember your password and ISP12345 doesn't work, you can go ahead and use the reset button within RenWeb or email edtechhelp@isp.edu.pa or come by the Tech Center today and get us to reset it manually. So let's go ahead and get started. The first thing we're going to do is open up a web browser. You can use Chrome, Firefox, or Internet Explorer. You'll go ahead and go to the ISP website of isp.edu.pa and click on Students, or hover over Students, excuse me, and then click on the shortcut to RenWeb. So let's pop on over to the Internet, and you'll see here we're at the ISP homepage, and under Quick Links, there is a drop-down menu that pops up with Students. You might have to scroll down a little bit on the website to see the link for RenWeb because it's towards the bottom, they're alphabetical. Click on RenWeb and it's going to go ahead and load you into the ISP homepage for our portal. You'll know you're at ISP obviously because of the logo and the picture of the school. If you've been here before on this computer, the district code would have saved. If not, this is where you would type in the IS-PAN. Then you'll put in your username, which is your email address, and so this demonstration, my email address is lfake@ispst.edu.pa, and I'll put in my password that I have saved. What's very important is a lot of students forget is to move it from parent to student. So when you click on the student button, you'll change over and hit login. If you get something that tells you incorrect or invalid credentials, then check your password or check your email address and make sure you're using your ISP student issued one. When you log in, you'll know you're there because it says your name. And so first we want to review where to change your password. If you go down to Family Information and you click on it, a menu selection will open and you'll see username and password. It's very simple. You click on here, you type in your old password, your current password, which would be the temporary reset or the one you have, and then you'll type in your new one twice, and please remember it must be 6 characters long, including at least one number and one letter. You may need to put in your user ID, which is that email address. Please do not change this outside of anything else than your school email address. So now to go back to course registration, if you did this last year, you'll remember it's under student information. If you don't remember, you'll just go ahead and click on student information. And under course requests, you'll have the option pop up. As you'll be a 12th grader next year, a lot of the work has been done for you because of your 2-year IB program. Make sure that it says 12th grade up here for you, otherwise we need to check your setting is in the system. Please remember the deadline is this Friday, March the 18th at 3 p.m. Your advisor and your counselors have given you other instructions on what to do with your paper. So here we're going to go ahead and get registered for some courses. Please remember, like I said, your 2-year IB program, everything has been cloned from what you're currently enrolled in to what you'll be enrolled in next year for your IB courses. If you've made changes recently, those should be reflected in our system, but if you're concerned, please check with your counselors. Up here in EdTech, we will not be able to help you with your course selections or your course tracking, but we can help you with the technology side of it if you're having problems with the system saving or entering your information. But we will not change your registration or your course load. You'll need to work with the counselors for that. Since all your core is in there, all we need to do is select whether or not you're on the Panama Diploma or the IB program, and whether you need any of the IB courses and some electives. So if you're seeking a Panamanian diploma like last year, you would pick on the menu. If you're not, then leave it blank. If you are, you would of course pick your IB diploma. If you're in the IB program, whether you're taking the full diploma or certificates, you need to indicate which one. If you're not doing either of the options, then please leave it blank. So here, if I was in the IB diploma program, I would select this. My core courses have already been loaded for me. And now I need to remember that I need to take IB TOK. So I'm going to select year two of TOK. When I scroll down here to the bottom, you're going to go ahead and see electives. And this is where we need to be clear about some things. Please remember that you get to select up to four electives. However, this selection is not a ranking nor a priority choice, and it does not help you choose on whether it's semester one or semester two. Based on your IB courses that you're enrolled in and based on when the classes of the electives you selected are available, you'll be put into them. However, if the courses are not available when you have free time, you may end up with a free block, or you may need to be visited with the counselor to go ahead and pick some alternative options and see what's available. Please also note that selecting the same option for all four requests or even two requests does not increase your chance of being put into that elective. If the elective is offered both semesters, depending on your schedule, it will be reflected in what's available. So we'll go ahead and select here. You'll see everything that's available to you, and I'm interested in maybe drawing, and I'd like to take something to do with fitness. And I'm looking for something with technology, so I want to maybe take computer studies. And I've been studying French, so I want to make sure to take the next level. So I'm going to move from my beginner class to my intermediate. And in case I can, I'll take a free block. So now you see I have my four electives and my free block choice. If you know you don't have a fourth choice, you can always leave the free block. However, the free block does not count as one of your four requests. So you can put in up to five options, actually, including your senior free block. It's very important that you remember to save. So I'm going to click save, and the screen will refresh. And what's important to see is up here it says course registration request has been saved. Now it's also important to know that if you have changes before March 18th, you can come back at any time. So if today you're not ready to make your choices or you left your paper at home, you can go ahead and practice and make sure it works. If you have any problems, please let us know up in the tech center and let your advisor know. If you don't have any problems or you practice, just remember to make sure to come back and double check or change everything in time for the deadline. We will only use the copy that is there as of 3 p.m. on this coming Friday. So that gives you time to think things over and make changes or talk to the counselors. And once you're done, all you need to do is scroll up to the top and log off. It's that simple. Thanks a lot for joining me. Have a wonderful day and good luck in your senior year.